Fusion splicing is the process of welding two fibers together by an electric arc. To begin, turn on the unit. It will start an initialization process, and the screen will show current program and other information, battery level, heat program, and fusion program. Select the appropriate fiber program, multimode, single mode, or other. Multimode fibers can be harder to fusion splice, as the larger core, with many layers of glass, are sometimes harder to match up, especially with fibers of different manufacturers. Select the correct protection sleeve. You have to select the lenght of the sleeve. Ensure that the V-grooves are clean. The V-groove is made of a brittle ceramic material. Slide a splice protection sleeve onto one of the fiber. Prepare the fiber to be spliced. Strip off a portion of fiber coating by using the fiber stripper to expose the proper lenght of bare fiber, usually 3.04 mm. Care must be taken to not nick the fiber during the stripping process, as it can cause cracks that may lead to fiber failure. Older fibers may become brittle and hard to strip. The optical fiber, whose coat is removed, is called bare fiber. Clean the bare fiber using a lint-free tissue and isopropyl alcohol. Cleave the fiber. The quality of the splice will depend on the quality of the cleave. Place the end of the fiber into the cleaver. Follow the instruction of your cleaver, aligning the end of the fiber coating with the mark on the rule of the cleaver. Each manufacturer's product is slightly different and requires different procedures. Do not clean the bare fiber after it has been cleaved. Don't let the bare fiber tip come in contact with any surfaces. Open the windshield of the splicer. Open the fiber holder lid and carefully place the cleaved fiber in the fiber holder. Ensure that nothing touches the bare fiber tip. Don't slide the tips of the fiber ends through the V-groove tracks. Make sure that the fiber tips are positioned between the center of the electrodes and the V-groove. These are the electrodes. Close the fiber holder lid while carefully holding the fiber at the proper position. Repeat the process for the second fiber, and set it on the other side. Close the windshield. The splicer will initiate the fusion splicing process. You can follow the process on the LCD monitor. A prefuse arc will clean the fiber ends and preheat the fibers for splicing. Then, the two fiber ends are pushed toward to each other. The cores of the fibers are aligned. Then, they will be fused by an arc cycle. The arc is discharged through the electrode pairs. The whole process of splicing is finished in few seconds. When fusion is completed, the splicing machine will inspect the splice and estimate the optical loss of the splice. It will tell the operator if a splice needs to be remade. Now you can open the windshield. A tension test is performed on the fibers. Wait until the tension test is completed, then open the fiber holder lids and remove the spliced fiber. Handle the spliced fiber carefully. Don't twist the fiber. Slide the splice protection sleeve over the spliced fiber. Place the spliced fiber in the heater. Close the heater cover. Activate the heater. When the heating operations is completed, remove the fiber from the heater and inspect the splice protection sleeve. Allow the sleeve to cool down. The fusion process is over. Visually inspect the splice after the process. Some flaws are acceptable, and some flaws are not acceptable, and require starting the splicing process over. Sometime, the splice can be improved by repeating the arc step, but never more than twice. All fusion splicers have maintenance requirements, which should be described in the operating manual. Besides cleaning regularly, they require electrode alignment and occasional replacement. Electrodes' life is generally about 2000 times. The electrodes will be oxidized, resulting in a discharge current too large, leading the splice loss value increases. You can clean them with medical cotton wool, moistened with alcohol. After washing several times, if the discharge current is still too large, replace the electrodes.